Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some have been a Bridget Bardot. Well, now it's time for the Cognac Show. I said cognac, ooh, ooh. I said cognac, ooh, ooh, ooh. I'm your bubbly blonde, fabulously dressed.
Yes, I'm Konya Aquila Lane, and we are here at 1050 2nd Avenue at Manhattan Art and Antique Center, just steps away from Pan Am Restaurant, the fabulous fresh French restaurant right across the street. And we're going to have dinner there after we do this wonderful interview. And I am talking to Andreas Aquino. He is an expert when it comes to fashion and design and art, and he has produced so many shows, so many internet shows and so many TV shows, and he's done a tremendous amount of work in fashion. So Andreas, tell my audience what brings you right here to the Manhattan Art and Antique Center.
Well, you know, it's very good. Thank you very much, first of all, so glad to see you again. I haven't seen you for a long time. Yes, I was invited here by a good friend of mine, Miriam Silverberg, that actually been following our fashion shows for many years. I'd say for probably over 10 years we've been working together and doing report on the events that we do. And now we came here to look at the possibilities of bringing the fashion show here.
That would be amazing.
Yes.
That would be tremendous if you could bring your shows here. That would be absolutely amazing.
The place is so inviting with so many beautiful things, antique art, that I think it's just a perfect combination to have fashion and art together. We always been fooling around with that, always have a small exhibition of art, but now I want to be right in the thick of thing and come here with all the art that's right around us and then work on this. So we're planning to maybe extend Fashion Week in September to add more days so we can come here and do a presentation here.
We don't want to wait till Fashion Week. You have to do something before that. You have to do something like next month, maybe.
Yeah. You know, I might take it.
I can't wait till Fashion Week. Come on.
Yeah, that's. Let's see what we can do. Let's see take care of that craving for fashion that happens all the time in New York City. So we'll see. We'll see. We are in discussion right now.
You have to work on doing some kind of a little cocktail soiree with the fashion show and everything else going on.
That sounds like a perfect combination, and this is the right place to do it. I think it's the right place to do it. They have the beautiful long corridor that the model can walk for like forever, so I think it would be really cool.
Well, you even have that staircase. People could be standing downstairs and the models could be going down those stairs too.
Yes, and that is always very beautiful because it looks very grand when the model come with a long gown coming down the steps. You know, used to see that.
Multiple fashion shows, yes. One straight and one going down the stairs.
We do both, combination perhaps, stairs and then straight. That's what I was thinking.
You have been producing fashion shows for a very long time. How many years have you been producing fashion shows?
Well, you know, Couture Fashion Week, we started this September will be our 26th season. We are the longest running Fashion Week event in New York under the same banner. Everybody else are come and gone on a period of time. We consistently done for 26 seasons.
26 seasons, that long. But you were doing it even before Fashion Week, I know that.
We started actually
working with Black Time magazine.
Way back then in 2003, we were doing shows here and then also in Palm Beach. So that's when I was working with Black Tie in combination. We were partnering on that. We used to go to Palm Beach and with the society people there and do the shows there. Then after that, I started going to Dubai and to Bucharest and India and different parts.
And Cannes, France.
And now we're doing Cannes, France. Every year we do the Global Short Film Awards, which will take place now on May the 20th at the Carlton. That's our next big event there. So we're very excited about that. We're doing a combination of live performances, fashion shows, and presenting 20 different awards to filmmakers from our event there. So it's bringing filmmakers from about 81 different countries around the world. And these are the best films that we get the awards at that time.
Exciting. You live a very exciting life, traveling around the globe, jet setting around the globe, capturing fabulous fashions in every city, Dubai, Paris, Cannes, New York City. What's the next city you're going to be doing?
Actually, after we finished in Cannes, then we go for the Grand Prix. We do a fashion show aboard a luxury yacht while we watch at the same time the Grand Prix in Monaco. And that's
my husband. I'm trying to get my husband to take me to Monaco for that.
This would be the right time.
That's his thing, the Grand Prix. He watches that every year.
It is beautiful. It's a beautiful thing.
So maybe we could
biggest party.
Maybe we could combine fashion with race car driving, and he'll take me to Monaco. Of course, I have to buy a whole new wardrobe to go to that.
Let's be sure we'll get you ready for that one, but you'll be fine. I think it'll be great.
You are such an exciting person. You do the best work. I've seen I have to tell you, the Couture Fashion Week, the internet videos are just outstanding.
The quality of
video is just superb. But you work very hard at this, and it's a hard job. It looks glamorous, but we know, Andres, it's hard work.
Well, behind the scenes, there's a lot of work, but there's a great deal of satisfaction when you see the models and you see the audience reacting to the beautiful garment and then the music and the sound and then the beautiful makeup and hair and the accessories. It's like the fantasy. We are merchants of fantasy. That's what we are. And we come up with this beautiful situation in which everybody gets totally involved and engaged, and they have these beautiful experiences. It's all about the beautiful experience. And we do it in New York, then we do it in Cannes, we do it in Monaco, but whatever you do it, it's always people having a great time and sharing with each other. Beautiful moment, beautiful memories.
Well, I have to tell you, Andreas, you keep doing it and you do a good job. Tell my audience, if we want to find out more information or learn more about you, where can we go? What is the website? Do you have a website?
Of course, we have many websites and many pages, but you can go to couturefashionweek.com, C-O-U-T-U-R-E, couturefashionweek.com, and then you get our schedule of event. Our next big event in New York will be September 8th through the 10th, and we have a lot of great designers coming from Russia, Indonesia, India, South America, China, you name it. It's just going to be amazing. In fact, I think it's going to be our biggest show this year, because we have the most...
We're having it, Couture Fashion Week, this year.
This year is going to be at the Crown Plaza Times Square. We're right there in Times Square. So it makes it very convenient for people from everywhere in the city to get to Times Square. So, it's the hub, and it's the heart of the world, practically. So it's very convenient for that purpose. And I think it's good because we also bring... we have so many press and so many designers coming from different parts of the world, so the whole international aspect is there, and that makes it very exciting, because that's New York, that melting pot,
You said it, darling. That's New York. One more time, the website. Where can we go?
Oh, you're a darling. CoutureFashionWeek.com. CoutureFashionWeek.com.
Fabulous. Give me a kiss. Yet. We'll be back in a moment with more interviews, more celebrities, right here at Cognac's Corner Magazine. Pink champagne kisses.
Thank you.
Greetings, welcome back. I'm Konyekwa Lalane, and we are here at Pan Am Restaurant, right here on 55th Street and 2nd Avenue, just steps away from 1050 2nd Avenue with the Manhattan Art and Antique Center. So when you are shopping for a full day of antiques and art, you can stop by and have a sumptuous Parisian dinner. And Chef Bernard, of course, is the executive chef and the owner of Pan Am Restaurant, authentic French cuisine. And we're sitting here with this fabulous array of new appetizers for the spring. Tell my audience what we're seeing here tonight.
Yeah, Cognac, what I want to let you know that we are lucky to have a location close to the Manhattan Art and Antique Show. That brings us so much new people every day. And everybody's like so enthusiastic by shopping at this antique center. This is said, I would like to tell you that this pink Prosecco is going to be our special of the summer, like the rosé Prosecco.
And the tell them it's the cognac drink.
Cognac drink, exactly. Now we're going to come back to the new appetizer that we have. This is a little pot. This is like a little ratatouille, which is a known mixed sautéed vegetable with a little chorizo. And egg that's put in, and it's cooked by the steaming of the ratatouille. And this one here, it's one of the classic chicken liver. Okay, it mixed with a little mushroom. We put some chanterelle. We put a little porcini mushroom with the calf's liver, a little chicken liver, sautéed with a little cognac, and that's about it. This is, which is a strictly French acquired taste. It's like a black pudding, which is a boudin noir choucroute, sauerkraut, in between two cakes of blood sausage. It's an acquired taste, blood sausage and sauteed onion, sweet onion. It's an acquired taste. Maybe not for everybody, but mostly for European. That's why we have it on the menu, and it's moving well.
It looks delicious. I mean, everything here looks absolutely delicious. Beyond everything. I can't wait to just divulge and eat everything on this table. It looks really amazing. Now, how do you feel about the Manhattan Art and Antique Center being? That's a nice afternoon for a lot of these people around the neighborhood.
We're lucky, as I said before, to be like a half a block away from the center, and a lot of people come in with what they bought and how disappointed they are because they can't afford, but they will come back and
save their money.
Yeah, exactly. To save their money to invest in art.
And so they just say, I need a drink. At Pan Am, I need some French cuisine. I need some comfort food, right?
Yes. So I want to also let your audience from the Art Antique Show that we have a happy hour going on all day. So even if they don't buy anything, we just welcome them here to de-stress.
I love it. De-stress. I love it. Tell my audience, where can we go to find out more information? What's the website?
Our website is Pan Am NYC. Okay, Pan Am stands for slang for in French for Paris, and it's a small little bistro, or rather a small compound little brasserie, and serving French little upscale dishes.
Love it.
At very affordable prices. Our
Facebook page.
Our prefix for dinner is like $39, four courses, and lunch we have just put a new menu, which is $22 for two courses, or $23 for three courses. That's the lunch special.
You're gorgeous.
Thank you. Thank you. You smell good, and you look absolutely gorgeous.
Oh, don't go away yet. We'll be back in a moment, darlings. More interviews coming up. Keep watching. Pink Champagne Kisses.
Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some of you know Bridget Fonda.
This is been a Crybaby Productions, darlings.